All right, the entire Friends from the Rochester Museum and Science Center are here. We have Tim and Kara, and you want to introduce our other guests?
Hey, so I've got Rocco. He's a crested gecko.
All right.
And I've got Sophie, and she's an African fat tail gecko.
All right, so it's reptile night.
It is reptile night here.
All right, who's going to tell us first about their...
Either one. I can go.
Okay.
We've got Rocco. He comes from New Caledonia. That's an island on the east side, east of Australia. Wow. He's a really cool gecko. He doesn't have any eyelids, so he uses his tongue to moisten his eyes and clean debris out of it. One of the coolest aspects of it is that he's got this little prehensile tail. Oh, looks like he wants to show you. He's also got some nanotechnology on his fingers. And on the end of his tail, little hairs that are made up of a bunch of little hairs after that are about 200 nanometers wide each.
Wow.
And they turn around and they hold on to, you were telling me today about who it was,
The Van der Waals forces.
Van der Waals, yeah. Yes. Yeah. So he actually can hold on to things like glass or go up a wall pretty easily.
Mm. Yeah, because people thought it was suction, but it's not at all. It's these tiny hairs, like you're
tiny
saying.
Tiny hairs that are grabbing hold. And and he can lose his tail. Most of the crested geckos in the wild.
How am I doing, huh?
You're doing great. most of them in the wild have lost their tail already. They lose their tail when they're being attacked by predators, and they may grab them by the tail and it snaps right off. These guys, they don't grow back on.
Now, we were talking too about that earlier, and we see his toes will hold on to ties too, right?
Yeah, okay. That's pretty well. Yeah,
that I was down in the Bahamas with a group of kids a couple weeks ago. Mm-hmm. There were anoles were all, but they'll lose their tail. And one of the things that a couple of kids that saw were amazed that it kept flopping after it fell off, which is great because the predator then
chases
it, and they have a chance of getting away. So that's very cool.
That's cool.
All right.
And Kara's got.
Yeah, and this is Sophie. She's an African fat tail gecko. There are some similarities and some differences. Biggest difference, I would say, with these guys would have to be she does have eyelids, which is actually odd for geckos.
Mm-hmm.
She does not have the nanopads on her feet, so she can't do scaling of glass and all that fun stuff. She is mainly on the ground. She has the same thing where she can lose her tail. She can grow it back. It just doesn't look as pretty. She is what is called a fat tail gecko, which
looks
is pretty
fat.
Obvious. She has a very fat tail. She stores fat in her tail, so that if she goes a few days without eating, she can actually pull from the fat in her tail, which is pretty neat.
Very cool. Now, the other thing I'm noticing, Tim, the difference in their eyes, and maybe this one here has the vertical iris.
The vertical iris, and the other thing this one has, if you see really closely, is this one has almost looks like eyelashes, and without the eyelids, so they're a little bit more to bear, so the eyes are a little tougher, and they also, that big long tongue, there he goes, I was hoping he was going to lick his eyelids on cue, but every now and again, there he goes, but he'll clean his eyes, and they're pretty cool, they're all colored for camouflage. Mm-hmm. He just loves the blue. Can't blame him. It's a good color.
Now, both these guys do. They both shed?
Yes.
Let's talk about how they grow.
Yeah, they would shed about every 4 weeks or so, both of them do. And these guys actually eat their skin after they shed it. So they'll shed once about a month and eat it.
A lot of nutrients there, right?
Yeah,
yes,
yep,
exactly.
Absolutely.
Very cool.
So you brought those two in. How many other different types of geckos are there?
It's about 1,500.
1,500,
so lots of them.
Wow.
I'm sure they're still finding more, if I had to take a guess.
The one you see a lot on the television is the, isn't that the leopard?
Yeah, the leopard gecko.
Leopard gecko.
Okay. Oh, is that the commercial one?
That's the commercial guy, yeah.
Okay. The famous one.
Yeah.
Rocco says he could do it. But he'd be sticking to everything. He's all right, though.
Now, you have these in your traveling, the traveling at the zoo there, but or the museum. Do these guys reproduce well in captivity?
We've never had them reproduce. They probably, if you get breeding pairs, they're probably fine. But like anything else, it takes a lot of care for reproducing because they're eggs and you're going to be turning around. You have to put them in an incubator or keep them with them. They make great pets.
Yeah.
They're easy keepers. They eat mostly crickets. I mean, this guy will eat a little fruit too, but we feed them mostly crickets.
All right.
And they're
what
great
could
fun.
You tell us about their colors?
Definitely for camouflage. Okay. They're colored for camouflage for sure, okay. Just for where they live. I mean, he lives higher up, so you can notice the more green on him, more brown on her because she's more on the floor. They also have really neat skin. She has, I always tell the kids, it reminds me a lot of a basketball if you touch her, because it's got those little circles there. More bumps than they are scales.
Okay.
And it will actually beat up the water. So if you were to spray her with water, it'll beat up. It won't soak in, which is pretty neat.
Very cool. Now, can we see the ears on these guys? I think that's awesome.
Cool, she's got bigger holes than these guys do.
And the other cool part is if you take a look right at the end of his tail, you can see that nanotechnology right at the end of the prehensile tail. So, and if you put your finger across that, and it's just those bristles, as it is in Latin, the word for setia, I think it is.
And so if students wanted to actually see these and others, where would they need to go?
Yes, so they'd have to come to the Rochester Museum and Science Center. We have these in our room. It's called the Carlson Inquiry Room. We hold birthday parties in that room. Okay. We do a summer camp in the room as well. We have a lot of open hours, super public, depending on when the kids are off of school.
Great. Well, thank you for bringing them on.
No, thanks for having us. Thanks for the loan of the time.
All right.
All right. If you want to know more about this animal and others like it, go to our website, homeworkhotline.org, click on the videos, and stay right there. We'll be back in a second.